Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. We're currently on our way to get some Starbucks because a girl is tired and she needs a coffee. I only ever drink coffee when I need to like go do something and I have no energy because my sleep patterns are trash. Anyways, so we're gonna go get that. I'm super excited. A few weeks ago I actually like tried this drink out and it's so good, like so good. So I'm super excited to get it. But yes, I'm only getting coffee because it is 8:55 in the morning and I have a tour of the school that I'm trying to go to at 10 a.m. So I'm just gonna go get my coffee and chit chat with you guys a little bit because I've been gone forever. But let's go. Starbucks secured. Found my coffee. I ordered it completely wrong, but I basically got a grande iced cinnamon dolce latte with 2 pumps of caramel syrup. So good, so freaking good. Let me go straight because there's too much traffic over here. So I hope I'm not running late. I don't even know where this school is at. I gotta put it on the GPS, but I record on my phone. So yeah, taste test. So good. I just got out of my, can never talk. Why? I don't know. Maybe because I've had like most of my coffee and it's basically like all sugar and I am very hyper and I most likely have like ADHD and OCD and I don't even know what. But anyways, that's not what this video is about. I want to address my drastic weight loss, which by the title of this video, this is all you've been waiting for. Not any of my rambling before. A few months ago, I was prescribed some medication and I just keep it in here just because for me to track it, like it has like the dates and all that stuff. But I actually haven't taken today's pill yet, but I was given citrulline, which is also Zoloft. I started off at 50. Well, the first time it was take, like I had to split it in half, so 25. And now I'm at 100. So this little pill right here, which I need to take, and I'm gonna take it with my coffee because I don't care. And don't mind my nail, these are press-ons. And yesterday I was doing some shopping and when I got back home, I was like, I looked at my hand and I was like, where the hell is my nail? But it's not the first time it happens. They've been on for like almost a week. And anyways, let's take this. But yes, so I've been taking this antidepressant for about, I would say 4 months now or 5 months. And it just, I didn't think the side effects would be this drastic. Okay, I was weighing probably 150 or like 60 pounds, give or take, maybe a little bit less, because over time I just kind of wasn't eating as unhealthy, I would say. So I did start losing weight, but then all of a sudden, as soon as I started taking my medication, it was like boom, 45 pounds gone. Couldn't eat. I completely lost my appetite. It was super hard, and it's still super hard to find things that I enjoy. Thank goodness I still have my sweet tooth. I can still eat candy, which I shouldn't be doing, but yes, I'm still able to like have sweets. I still love fruit, but for about, I would say 3 months, because I feel like I've been on it for like 4 months now, or maybe the first 2 months. My brain is just like all over the place. But for the first 2 months for sure, I was not eating. I would have maybe an acai bowl here and there, just fruit, crackers, water, that's it. And I wasn't hungry, I just wasn't eating. So for 2 months straight. No eating, no type of protein, nothing. My body kind of ate away at the fat, if that makes any sense. So I'm currently 116 pounds, which is so crazy to me, because even when I graduated from boot camp, like from the Marine Corps boot camp, I was 118 pounds. Like, I am skinnier than when I did that training. And it's like, how? I feel like a skeleton right now. I don't want to brag about my weight loss. I don't really want to encourage people to do this because it wasn't healthy, you know? So this is why I haven't really addressed it any like that. But I'm coming on here just to talk to you guys about the reality of mental health. I struggle with so many different type of mental health disorders. I have anxiety. I'm taking an antidepressant for my depression, which it's been great. As you can see, like, I haven't really stopped smiling this whole video. So definitely I don't regret taking the medication, but I really wish that it didn't affect me as much as it did. But I don't regret it, because like, I wasn't happy with the way that I looked before. So like, yes, I lost weight, yay for me, but it wasn't a healthy way, and it wasn't the way that I wanted to do it. It was kind of out of my control at that point. I really couldn't force myself to eat. I still can't really force myself to eat. My dosage was raised about 2 weeks ago, and up until then I started getting my appetite back, but now it's kind of like not here again. So I'll just eat when I feel like I should be eating, if that makes sense. So I'll have at least lunch and possibly dinner. I've also been drinking smoothies. Like, I go to this little smoothie place out in here in Florida, and I have at least one smoothie a day, which I know that there's like protein in there and like fruits and all types of nutrients to make me be healthy again, because I generally don't feel like I'm currently healthy, like at all. And it's crazy to think that I weigh 116 pounds and I still feel fat. I don't know how to change that. Like, body dysmorphia is something else. Like, it will destroy at your brain. For the longest time, I was overweight for over 3 years. So when I would look at myself in the mirror, like, that's all I would see, you know? It was a different me. And I was comfortable with that. I was super comfortable with that. And all of a sudden, boom, lost the weight. And it happened too quick for me to even realize that it was happening. I noticed it back in December when I went to go visit my siblings in Boston, well, in Newton, because that's where I'm from. So I went to go visit them, and I just started noticing little just weight loss here and there. And this was before I even started taking the medication. That's what I was saying. I'm not sure how much I was weighing at. I was probably about 150 pounds right before I dropped this drastic weight. And I see people like just congratulating me on my weight loss, but I generally don't. I'm not proud of it, because I would have done it a different way. If I wanted to lose weight, I would have lost it years ago. But I was so comfortable in my body. I was so comfortable in wearing size 11 jeans. I was in size 11 jeans, and right now I'm in a 0 or 00. And it's so crazy to me. I was just comfortable, you know, and I didn't really want to change, because if I wanted to change, I would have done it years ago. But I was just super depressed, super, super depressed. I would stuff my mouth with like everything. This was like in those 3 years while I was still in the military. I just didn't care. I was sitting behind an office having my Starbucks every day, and it all caught up to me. I would eat McDonald's pretty much every day during my lunch break. At one point, I was living pretty far from base, and I had to drive an hour in the morning to go to work, and it would take me 2 hours to get home. By the time I got home, it was like 8 o'clock. I was not gonna cook dinner. So I would just eat out. and I was eating out, and boom, just gained so much weight to the point that when I got out of the military, I was like, what happened? Like, I look back at all these pictures and it's like, wow, like, why did I let myself get to that point? You know, even though I was overweight, I still liked the way that I looked. I had no problem with the way that I looked. I even made an account, you know, like, and I made good money on there. So to a certain point, yes, I didn't like my body, but the thing is, I was just used to it. So it's like half and half. Like, I was okay with the way that I looked, but I also would prefer to look a different way, if that makes any sense. But I'm rambling like crazy because this is just how I talk. Like, my boyfriend, he's always like, all right babe, like, get to the point, because I just ramble like a lot, a lot. Enough about me rambling about nonsense. This is me. Like, I currently take an antidepressant, and if you don't agree with me taking medication, don't care. This is me, this is my body. I feel so much better now that I'm on this medication. I'm able to smile. Like, I have my grumpy days, of course, but today, I don't know if it's because I had coffee or like what, but I'm extremely happy. And good things are coming, and I cannot wait for those good things to get here. I can see the light at the end of the tunnel, and I am so beyond blessed to still be here today, because a few years ago, I would not have even said that. It wasn't even in my mind to think like I'm blessed, but I really am blessed. I have a supporting family, I have a supporting and loving boyfriend, everything is just there, you know. So please, if you find yourself struggling, feel free to reach out. You can message me on Instagram, comments, like, you can do whatever you feel as though you need to do to get some help. If you want to talk, I'm all ears. I talk a lot, but I listen, and if you need someone, go ahead, DM me, and I will most likely respond, because I'm not famous. Like, I barely have any Instagram followers, so go ahead, message me on there if you need somebody to talk to. I'll always have my ears open and my heart open to you guys. Thank you so much for listening to me ramble about, you know, craziness, but mental health is very important to me. I've lost a few people due to mental health, and it's not something I would ever want to put my family through, you know. I found myself in a very dark spot a few years ago, and if I'm being real, those thoughts did come through my mind. I didn't want to take any action on there because I didn't want to hurt my family, but I decided to deal with the suffering by myself, and it kind of made things worse. And a few months ago, I did make the decision that I needed some change in my life. I was tired of waking up with no energy, just not wanting to do anything, not wanting to talk to anybody, just completely hating myself, you know. And now, a few months later on the medication, like, I can say that I love me. I'm still trying to figure out who I am, don't get me wrong, but I love me, and people love me, and I feel like as long as I love me, that's all that matters, because it's all I've ever wanted since I was probably about 13. That's when my self-esteem completely, and I've had moments where, like, it's gone up and down, but 10 years ago, that's when it just declined. And it's so crazy that it's been 10 years, but I'm doing a lot better now. So thank you so much for listening to me ramble. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and like I said, if you feel yourself in a tight position in your life and you just need someone to talk to, feel free to message me and I will be all ears. But yeah, that's it. Hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you guys soon. Bye guys.